Apple just released iOS 14.6 this week, and with it, many new features. So we'll cover what's new in iOS 14.6 and whether or not you should update. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today, we're talking all about the latest iOS 14.6 update. Specifically, we're gonna talk about what's new in iOS 14.6, we'll talk about some performance in iOS 14.6, and we'll even touch on battery life and more. So are you ready? Then let's go. So what's new in iOS 14.6? Quite a lot, actually, but let's kick things off with update number one, and that's a handy new accessibility feature. You can now unlock your phone after restart with your voice. Now, this one is available for users who have voice control enabled. And if you're wondering how to enable voice control, you're just gonna head to Settings, Accessibility, and Voice Control. Tap Setup Voice Control, and then once everything's all done and set up, you're going to have a microphone icon in the top left, indicating that voice controls are enabled. So here's what this sounds like. Tap three, tap two, and now I've unlocked my phone using my voice. iOS 14.6 update number two, Apple Music lossless audio and Dolby Atmos support. Kind of. I'll show you what I mean. Though the actual option won't be available on the music app until some point next month, users will now see the support has been added for Apple's new lossless audio and Dolby Atmos functionalities. So you can see a couple of badges added here in the Apple Music app. So essentially in 14.6, Apple is preparing users for better quality audio and more immersive audio. And you can tap on these badges for more information too. Now on to update number three, paid content support for Apple Podcasts. This is huge for podcast creators. So in the podcast app, you'll now have a paid subscription support for both channels and shows. So podcasters can offer exclusive paid subscriber content now directly from Apple Podcasts. Now from the user standpoint, you're gonna notice in your profile here, you now have a manage subscriptions option. So if you decide to pay to subscribe to your favorite podcast, this is where you would manage those. FYI, this does not affect any free content, and of course, it's totally up to you, the user, to decide to pay for any additional content. iOS 14.6 update number four, Apple Card Family Group Spending Features. Whew, say that 10 times fast. In 14.6, Apple wants to make it easier to track and manage your family spending together. So users are gonna be able to add up to 5 family members to their account, and they have to be users of that same family sharing group and also over the age of 13. Now, the cool thing here is that you can track expenses and set spending limits. So obviously to have this feature, you need to have Apple Card already. Then you'd be able to share your card. So think, you know, you could share your card with your kids in order to help them build up their credit. Now, something to keep in mind here is that they're probably gonna get access to your higher credit limit, so it's a higher limit than they would get on their own. So be mindful of that and be sure to set those limitations. 14.6 feature number five, there are new AirTag tracking functions. If you have an AirTag, you're gonna notice in your lost mode of the Find My app, you can now add an email address instead of a phone number, which is great if you don't want people to have your personal number should they find your device. However, the other change, even if you do have your number set up here, now in 14.6, anyone that finds your device won't actually be able to see the entire number. Some of it's gonna be hidden in order to offer extra privacy to you. So now let's talk a little bit about battery life in 14.6. To be honest, I haven't really noticed that much of a difference really since 14.5 and 14.5.1. So it's really the same for me, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, because think about it, it's kind of good. I'm running more apps than ever, storing more content than ever, and yet my battery life remains consistent. So this is a good thing, a positive overall. And speaking of running more apps and storing more media than ever, let's talk overall performance. iOS 14.6 delivers. It does not disappoint. Now, keep in mind, I am using an iPhone 11 Pro, so I have noticed a slight change for the better here on my device, but really I think where you'll notice this difference would be on older devices, specifically if you had some of those startup issues that were widely reported. That's one of the bug fixes in iOS 14.6. They addressed that. So now the big question, should you update to iOS 14.6 or wait until the next iteration? For me, it's a big yes. You should update to iOS 14.6. I've been using it for a few days now. I've had no issues. The performance and battery life have been great. So if you're really into Apple Music or you have AirTags, if you have Apple Card and you want to do those spending features, it's really something that I think you should take advantage of in 14.6. There were also a ton of other bug fixes in iOS 14.6 that are way too many to name in this video, plus of course some security patches. So it's really important that you update your iOS to ensure everything's running smoothly for you. So what are your favorite iOS 14.6 features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this video, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more iOS videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time.